So is the F-35 perfect? It absolutely isn't, but it's also in its infancy. With the version of airplanes that we fly here and that are currently being fielded, there's a lot of technology that's still being built and still being refined. My sole charge in life is to go out and either find ways to break the airplane or find ways to make the airplane break the things on the ground that it's supposed to. The current cadre of F-35 pilots right now are all highly experienced pilots with well over 1,000 hours, but I'm not building an airplane. I'm not refining an airplane for a highly experienced pilot. I'm refining an airplane for a pilot that has 150 hours that just graduated the B course, that's being called into some conflict somewhere in the world. The next gen or fifth gen mentality in developing these new airplanes is also the software that goes into them. I don't just sit in my jet and figure out things that are wrong and send an email out to somebody. I actually get to go and meet face-to-face with the engineers at Lockheed and explain to them from my perspective what it's like sitting in the cockpit, what I see is wrong, or maybe it's something that's not wrong, but it's not optimally engineered for the way that a pilot views and sees the world in three dimensions at 35,000 feet. So this airplane was in fact designed to fight the next generation of wars, and it's hard for us as a nation to forecast what area of responsibility we're going to be fighting in next. We're verifying that the back-end computer systems, the secure deploy facilities, all those natural inherent pieces of a fighter squadron outside of the fighter jet itself are capable of deploying to a new location and setting up operations.